Consider the case here where the two cells PV cell 1 and PV cell 2 have characteristic as shown here. There are non-identical characteristics. However, the VOC point is identical. Paralleling these type of cells will also lead to exactly similar nature of the resulting IV characteristic as we saw for identical cells being paralleled. If you consider the case when the load R0 is short-circuited, then the load line is the vertical axis, x-axis. The operating point is nothing but addition of these two currents ISC1 and ISC2. So ISC becomes ISC1 and ISC2. The other operating point, of course, is VOC. These being parallel, VOC1 is equal to VOC2 is equal to VOC. Any other operating point can be obtained by changing the load, putting in some finite value of the resistance and the load line, and the voltage developed across the panels will define this operating point. So I1 plus I2 will be the height of this, and the voltage developed across the load will be this VT. And so on, if you sweep this load line, you will land up with this type of IV curve for the combined system, having non-identical characteristic but identical VOC point. So you see that this is very similar to the IV characteristic of the identical cells in parallel. Now let us consider cells that are totally non-identical. Both the short circuit points and the VOC points are different for both the cells. And let us see how to derive the overall characteristics, IV characteristics of the cells in parallel, non-identical cells in parallel. ISC1 and ISC2 are the short circuit parameters for the two cells, and VOC1 and VOC2 are the open circuit voltage parameters for the two cells respectively. Now consider a situation where R0 is zero, that is the external terminals of the parallel combination system is short circuited, the load line is vertical, and we can get one operating point of the resultant IV characteristic, which is the summation of these two values, which is ISC1 plus ISC2. Now, let us introduce some resistance R0. The load line is like this. It has a finite resistance value and therefore a finite slope. Now, obtaining this operating point is well known, and we have seen that even the other cases. We have the corresponding currents at this point I1 plus I2. This is the current value, and VT the voltage value which is occurring across the parallel cell combination. Now, let us increase VT by increasing R0 such that VT is exactly equal to the VOC2 value, means the open circuit voltage of the PV cell 2, and this is indicated by this vertical line. So I have drawn this vertical line which is just passing through VOC2. You will notice that the cell 2 operating point is here as indicated by the arrow. The current I2 is 0 at this point, and the entire load current is given by cell 1. So this point here would be the operating point of PV cell 1, and this would also be the operating point of the resultant cell. Now by shifting the load line, we will achieve one more operating point for the combined parallel system as shown here. Now at this operating point, you will see that VT, the terminal voltage, is exactly equal to VOC2, that is the open circuit voltage of cell 2. And at this operating point, cell 2 contributes zero current. This will be zero current. Therefore, I will be totally equal to I1, which will be also the current flowing through the load. Notice that this operating point falls exactly on the IV characteristic of the PV cell 1. This is because I2 is equal to 0 and there is no contribution from cell 2. Let us shift the load line further down along the horizontal axis. In that case, R0 is infinite, which means that the terminals are open circuited. In that case, VT represents the open circuit voltage of the combined parallel system. I have drawn a line here passing through this point here, and this point here pointed by the arrow is the open circuit voltage of the combined system. And this line just is a marker, and this open circuit voltage is in between VOC1 and VOC2. Why should it be so? To answer that, first let us extend the IV characteristic of the PV cell 2 down below so that it intersects this line. Now you see that the IV characteristic of PV cell 2 is in the fourth quadrant. This is the fourth quadrant, and it's a sinking quadrant, not a sourcing quadrant. Remember that only the first quadrant is a sourcing quadrant. So now this intersects at this point, and we have two marker points here. This small marker here indicates that the PV cell 2 will operate at that operating point, and PV cell 1 will operate at this operating point. This current, the current here indicated in red, and the current here indicated by a green line, will match each other exactly. So let me zoom this so that you get a better view. This height here is the current I1, and this height here is the current I2. I1 and I2 will match and cancel each other. Notice that I1 is still in the first quadrant, positive. I2 is in the fourth quadrant, negative. And therefore, I1 and I2 will subtract exactly to zero, and that zero will be this point, which is the open circuit voltage point of the combined system. With the open circuit point available, we can now drag the entire characteristic to get the overall IV characteristics of the parallel system. So this would be the open circuit operating point, and this is the VOC voltage level, which occurs in between VOC1 and VOC2. So at this operating point, PV cell 2 is operating in the fourth quadrant, it is sinking. PV cell 1 is always in the first quadrant and sourcing.